Fifth standard, term 3, CSC, lesson 17. Indians whom we are proud of. Saraka was an Indian physician who lived circa 900 and 600 before Christ. In Sanskrit, Saraka is a term for a wandering religious student for a ascetic. According to one legendary account, the serpent king Sesa once visited the earth. He was the recipient of Ayurveda. He was moved when he saw men suffering with disease. He was rebuilt himself as Saraka. He then composed a new book on medicine based on older work of Agnivesa. His book is known as Saraka Samhita, which in an early test on Ayurveda is said that death is essential for good health and chief disease. But at the same time, while some food is an important cause of disease, it suggests that food as source of speed, nutritive values as well as physiologic substance that are like drugs inside human body. Nutrients are necessary for expedient recovery from sickness. Now, I will tell you about what are the important points. In first paragraph, we have Saraka, who lives circa 900 and 600 before Christ. Country, Sanskrit. According to the one legendary account, the serpent king Sesa first visited the earth. He was the recipient of Ayurveda. He was reborn himself as Saraka. New book on medicine was an older work of Agnivesa. His book is known as Saraka Samhita, test on Ayurveda. Nutritive values as well as physiologic substance that are like drugs inside human body. Nutrients are necessary for expedient recovery from sickness. That is the important point about Saraka. Let us know about Sushruta. Sushruta was an ancient Indian surgeon. He was the author of the treatise Sushruta Samhita. He is known as the father of plastic surgery, and the Sushruta Samhita is identified as one of the best and outstanding commentary on medical science of surgery. He is said to have been a physician originally of South India, active in Varanasi. His period is usually placed between the period of 1200 before Christ, 1600 before Christ. His special field are plastic surgery, anesthesiology, dentistry, and obstetry and gynecology. The statues dedicated to Sushruta are Haridwar. The important point are Sushruta was an ancient Indian surgeon. He was the author of the treatise Sushruta Samhita. He is known as the father of plastic surgery. Best and outstanding commentary on medical science of surgery. Originally of South India, active in Varanasi. His special field are plastic surgery, anesthesiology, dentistry, obstetry, and gynecology. Statue of Sushruta is in Haridwar. Thank you. Let us see about Kalidasa. Kalidasa was a classical Sanskrit writer. He was widely regarded as the greatest poet and the dramatist in the Sanskrit language. His age, period of living, cannot be dealt with precision. He is most likely fell within the 5th century AD. His play and prose are primarily based on the Hindu Puranas. His period was linked to the reign of 1. Vikramaditya, Chandragupta, 2. and Satagupta. Kalidas' period is linked to their reign. His name, along with poet Bhairavi's name, is mentioned in one of the stone inscriptions that 634 CE found at Ayodhya. His famous works are Sagutalam, Raghuvamsam, குமாரா சம்பவம் அண்ட் மெகா சந்தேசம் ஐஸ் வர் ஆர் இன் சங்கிரித் ஹிஸ் ஏஜ் வாஸ் த ஏஜ் ஆஸ் சங்கிரித் ரிவிவல் The important points are Kalidasa was a classical Sanskrit writer, greatest poet and dramatist in the Sanskrit language, 5th century. His play and poetry are primarily based on the Indic Puranas. His period was linked to the reign of one Vikramaditya, Chandragupta and Sankhyagupta. His name along with poet Bharatiya's is mentioned is one of the stone inscription that 634 CZ found at Hay Hall. His famous work are Sagutala, Raghuvamsam, Kumara Sambhavam and Mega Sandesham. All his works are in Sanskrit. He is as old as the age of Sanskrit revival. Thank you. Let us see about Mian Tenshin. He was born at Dehat in Gwalior around 1493 CE. His birth name was Ramtanu Pandey. He died in 1585 in Agra. He was a prominent Hindustani classical music composer, musician and vocalist. Known for a large number of compositions and also an instrumentalist who popularized and improved the plucked rabab of Central Asian origin. He was among the Navaratna Nine Jewel at the court of the Mughal Emperor Jalaluddin Akbar. Akbar gave him the title Mian, an honorific meaning Lianin Man. No. Such was the power of his music that when he used to sing in the court of Akbar, it is said that candles used to light up automatically. Tenshin was buried in the mausoleum complex of his Chifti master Sheikh Muhammad Gauss in Gwalior. According to legend, Tenshin's son Bilas Khan, in his grave composed Bilas Khan story. Many admirers are convinced that his death was caused by a fire while he was singing the Raga Dipaka. The important point are Mian Tenshin was born at Behat in Gwalior around 1493 CE. His birth name was Ramtanu Pandey. He died in 1585 in Agra. He is an Hindustani classical music composer, musician and vocalist, and also an instrumentalist. Improved the plucked rabab of Central Asian origin. Navaratna Nine Jewel at the court of the Mughal Emperor Jalaluddin Akbar. Akbar gave him the title Mian, as known as Lianin Man. It is said that candle used to light up automatically. Tenshin was buried in the mausoleum complex of his city master Sheikh Muhammad Gauss in Gwalior. According to legend, Tenshin's son named Bilas Khan in his grave composed Bilas Khan story. Tenshin's death was caused by a fire. Well, he was singing the Raga Dipaka. Thank you. Let us see about Sir Syed Ahmed Khan Bahadur. Sir Syed Ahmed Khan Bahadur, October 17, 1817, March 27, 1818, was a teacher and politician. He was also a social reformer. He founded the school that would later become Aligarh Muslim University. In 1857, there was a rebellion in India. It is known as the First Indian War of Independence. During this time, Sir Syed kept loyal to the British. he has to save money urgently. After the rebellion, he wrote a book where he said the British were in fact those who caused the rebellion. Sir said, believed that Muslims were in a bad position in India because of their conviction. India at the time was occupied by the British. Sir Syed therefore introduced the Western style of scientific working and organized Muslim intellectuals. He also thought that all Indian Muslims should use Urdu to talk to each other. He was unhappy about the position of Muslims in India as their social and economic status were declining. According to Sir Syed, Muslims had to bring a positive approach to the British and accept their way of education. He wanted the Muslims to benefit from the British. To achieve this task, he had to bring about cooperation between the Muslims and the British. The important point is October 17, 1817, March 27, 1898. He was a teacher and politician and also a social reformer. Later he became Aligarh Muslim University. In 1857 there was a rebellion in India. It is known as the First Indian War of Independence. Sir Syed kept loyal to the British. He also saved money urgently. After the rebellion, he wrote a book where he said the British were in fact those who caused the rebellion. Sir Syed believed that Muslims were in a bad position in India because of their conviction. India at the time was occupied by the British. Therefore introduced the Western style of scientific working and organized Muslim intellectuals. He also thought that all Indian Muslims should use Urdu to talk to each other. The position of Muslims in India as their social and economic status were declining. Muslims had to bring a positive approach to the British and accept their way of education. He wanted the Muslims to benefit from the British. To achieve this task, he had to bring about cooperation between the Muslim and the British. Okay. Let us see about Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore is a great national poet. He is the author of our national anthem. He was born in an aristocratic family in Kolkata. He had his education in English, but learned Bengali at home. He wrote his poem in Bengali. He was one of the greatest lyric poets of the world. He was a true patriot and loved India, his motherland, and Bengal is home. He has written a number of patriotic poems which are short and beautiful. One of his collection of poems, known as Gitanjali, earned him the Nobel Prize for Literature. He has also written plays, dance, drama, short story, and novel. He studied at International University and Shantiniketan. He was traveled all over India and a number of countries in the world. He was a friend of Gandhiji and they had great respect for his father. Gandhiji called him Gurudev and Rabindranath Tagore called him the Mahatma. Did you know her national song is Vande Mataram, written by Bankimchandra Chatterjee? The important point is Rabindranath Tagore is a national poet. He is the author of the national anthem. He was born in the aristocratic family in Kolkata. His education is in English, but he learned Bengali at home. He wrote hard poems in Bengali. His motherland are Bengal. He has written a number of patriotic poems which are short and beautiful. His poems known as Gitanjali earned him the Nobel Prize for Literature. He has also written play, dance, drama, short story and novel. He started an international university at Shantiniketan. He was traveled all over India. His best friend is Gandhiji. who called him Gurudev and Rabindranath Tagore called him the Mahatma. Thank you.
Fifth and our term 3 says lesson 17.
Indians whom we are proud of.
Like, subscribe, கல்வி முதற்கண்ண பெல் ஐக்கான் பிரஸ் பண்ணுங்க.